Hello everyone, it's Lindsay, and today I have a journaling Bible review for you guys. Grab a snack, send your kids outside to play, grab something to drink. This is gonna be a little bit longer of a video because I have a lot of things to cover, but these Bibles were sent to me by Thomas Nelson Publishers. They do a King James and a New King James Version journaling Bibles, and so they had some new ones that they released and reached out and asked if I'd be interested in reviewing them and sharing them with you guys. And I said, absolutely. So they went ahead and let me pick two different Bibles. I got to pick one for me to keep and work in and one to do a giveaway with. So this is the one that will be the giveaway. This is the King James Version, and it is so gorgeous. I had such a hard time deciding which Bible to keep and which to give away. But I kept the New King James and then decided to give away the King James Version. But if you know me, you know that my heart beats fast for watercolor florals. So this is so, so pretty. So this will be for the giveaway. I will talk at the end of this video how you can enter that giveaway. So I'm gonna set that aside so we don't get it messy or dirty. And then I have this one that I've been playing with. So they did send me these Bibles for review. I do wanna mention that when companies do that, I'm always very honest about the products, and I let them know that I'm gonna be very honest about the products. And I do ask for a period of time once I receive the product to have it in my hands and play with it and explore it before I bring it to you guys. So just know, nobody pays me or tells me what to say to you guys. I'm always very honest whether I pay for something or it's sent to me. So just to, you know, clear all that up, but these were sent to me for review. And I really have enjoyed this Bible as I've worked in it, and I think there are some features that you guys are really going to enjoy and have been asking for. So I am going to compare some of the things in this Bible to the Crossway ESV journaling Bible that I use on my channel. I've always been a lover of these ones just because my church reads in the ESV translation, and so that's why I've always kind of reached for these ones. But I know there are a lot of people out there that prefer other translations. Now, I want to say about translations that I would encourage you to do your research and prayerfully consider what translation you think is going to be best for you. I know there are diehard people who are committed to only one translation, and that is it. But I would encourage you to kind of research that. And I like to read from a lot of different translations. I read from ESV, CSB, NIV for studying. And then I also will occasionally read from something like the Message. I don't like to study from the Message, because it's not always accurate, but it's easy to read and kind of, I don't know, just use it to kind of get an overview of what a passage is talking about. But truthfully, unless you're reading the original Greek and Hebrew manuscripts, all Bible translations are a translation, are an interpretation of those original texts. So just keep that in mind. They are done by man, and so there is going to be errors in no matter what translation you pick up, but just do your research to find one that's as accurate as you can. So all that to say, this is the New King James Version, and it is very similar in size to my Crossway Bible. And so I know a lot of people watch my videos and will comment about how a product behaves differently in their Bible than it did in mine. And so I want to kind of talk about, you know, the things that I tested out in here and how it reacted. And so that way you know if it's going to react similarly to what you see on my channel. And these Bibles are marketed as journaling Bibles, and they can either be used for art journaling or just note taking. So keep that in mind. If you stumbled upon this video for a Bible review and you are totally turned off by art journaling, don't worry. I'm going to address some things if you're not into art journaling with this Bible. And I actually will not be using this Bible for art journaling, so I will talk about that. But it's about the same size. This is a hardbound cloth covered Bible. They do have several different ones over there. They have this really beautiful like gray leather wrapped Bible. It was so hard to decide which ones I wanted to ask for, but I landed on this one. It's hardcover, cloth bound, and so you can see it's about the same size. I have worked in this one, so it's a little bit warped, but same heights and thickness. One thing you will notice is that my Crossway Bible only has one ribbon. The Thomas Nelson Bibles have two ribbon markers, and that's super nice if you are using this as your primary Bible and you want to keep track of where your church sermon series are and where your own personal reading is. Then you can have two different markers going at the same time. So I do prefer that this has the two markers. I've used both softbound and hardbound. I don't know that I really have a preference. I've been working in a soft bound, but this does have a lay flat technology. And so when you open it up, it does lay flat, which is nice with a hard bound and for writing in it and coloring it and things like that. It is a journaling Bible, so it does have the margins. I did measure out the margins, and the margins in the Crossway Bible are just shy of 2 inches, and these are just over 2 inches. So you do get about a quarter, I think it's about a quarter of an inch or an eighth of an inch wider margin in the Thomas Nelson Bible. So that is nice that you get just a smidge more margin space. One thing I will point out, and it's probably kind of hard to see on camera, just the lighting and stuff, but the Crossway Journaling Bibles have a cream page, and the Thomas Nelson Bibles are a little bit more cream even than the Crossway. And I know a lot of people ask for stark white pages. Now, there are a few Bibles out there that have the stark white pages. Most of them have artwork already printed in there, or as a trade-off, you end up with darker journaling lines on the white pages. So I don't mind the cream pages. It doesn't bother me. And when they were designing this Bible, the main reason for doing that is for ease of readability. So before we do art, before we write and take notes and anything like that, the most important thing is reading your Bible. And so they approach these with that in mind. And so I, of course, read and study from other Bibles. I don't use my journaling Bible to read and study from. However, I will be using this solely for note-taking in sermons, Bible studies, and things like that. So I won't be doing artwork in here. So I will actually be reading and taking notes in this Bible. And so I appreciate that it has the cream pages, so it's a little bit easier on the eyes. So just keep that in mind. That's why they did that. There is some journaling lines. I know a lot of people ask for just blank margins. There is not yet a Bible on the market that has no journaling lines, but these are very faint. They're pretty comparable to the ones in my Crossway Bible. And these are nice for if you are only taking notes or doing your journaling. That way you can make sure everything is nice and straight. If you are doing artwork in here, it's pretty easy to cover up those lines, and they're not super, super noticeable. So that doesn't really bother me. Now, the font is 8-point font, which seems a little bit small, but they did design a very unique, special font specifically for their Bibles. And so it's supposed to be a little bit easier to be read. The 8-point font doesn't really bother me too much. I will say that it's easier to read out of the Thomas Nelson Bible than it is in my Crossway Bible. And again, I don't know if that's the color of the page or the specific font. It does seem like just a hair bigger than the Crossway. I wouldn't even say it's a full point, but it is a hair bigger looking than it is in my Crossway Bible. Some other nice little features is like this. So the inside cover has a printed paper and an area to write your name. The Crossway Bibles come with a cream insert. So you can customize this, but if you're not looking to fuss around with glues and papers like I do in mine, it's kind of nice that it's already set up and pretty on the inside for you. And then there's, of course, you know, just regular, like what you would expect to find in any Bible. You have your table of contents, both in the order that it appears in the Bible, and then also alphabetical order. And then you have some information about the translation. So like I said, this is the New King James Version. The one I'm giving away is the King James Version. I would encourage you to read that information there. And so you do have that. And then you dive in to the pages. And so you do have a nice, you know, book marker opening. And then you've got, you know, your text. One thing that I think will draw a lot of you into this particular Bible is that Jesus's words are in red. So I get a lot of questions about that. My Crossway Bible does not have this feature. Any of the Bibles I have shown on my channel do not have Jesus's words in red. And so I know a lot of people request that. So you do have that in this particular Bible, which is really nice. And then like the Psalms are, it is single column, so the Psalms, you get a little extra space just the way that it's written out, so you do have plenty of margin space in the Psalms and Proverbs. and some of those Older Testament books that are written that way. So you have tons and tons of space in there. And then the page thickness, it does say that it is a little bit thicker of a page since it's a journaling Bible. I would say it's pretty comparable to the thickness of pages in my Crossway Bible, but it is still thicker than, say, my Zondervan study Bible, like a typical Bible page. This is a little bit thicker than that. So it is nice for, you know, writing and taking notes. And like I said, I took this to church. I'm filming this Sunday night. I took this to church with me this morning and fully intend on taking sermon notes. So even if you don't want to art journal, you can use this to write out prayers. Maybe you just want to use this as a legacy Bible to write prayers for a grandchild or your child or something like that, and then just, you know, keep it to the margin. You definitely can do that. The back has, again, printed paper. Some information about the font type that they developed for their Bibles. And then another unique thing that I really like about this is the back has these blank note pages. So a lot of time on my channel, I will say, you know, always test products in the back of your Bible before you take it into your Bible if you're worried about bleed through. And so with the Crossway Bibles, my back pages are measurements. And so it's a little bit more difficult to, you know, see tested products because you have all this print back here. And there's not really a lot of blank pages. So, I mean, I guess you can see how products are going to react over print, like if you're going to go over the text or something like that, but you don't have a lot of blank space. So here you have these note pages. They are lightly lined. So if you were going to use this just for note-taking or something like that, you know, important dates or whatever you want. You do have those lined pages, but I think this is great for testing products, and that's actually what I used that for in here. And so I tested a variety of products, whether they are for art journaling or just for note-taking and writing. Now, keep in mind, I did not test out every single product that's out there. I know I'm going to get questions from you guys, you know, what about this product? What about that product? I try to just stick to products that I show on my channel, or I know you guys have asked about and talk about. And I would just encourage you, if you have questions, test it out in the back of your Bible. I don't have the time or the resources or the products to test every single product out there. So let's kind of talk about the products that I did test. Overall, I would say these pages are very comparable to my Crossway Bibles that I show on my channel. And so I think this would be a great substitute for that. But let's kind of break down each product and kind of go over it. For ink, if you're going to be stamping things in your Bible, I prefer to use VersaFine Onyx Black ink. That's the ink that I use 99% of the time on my channel. This is permanent once it's dry. However, it does have a tendency to bleed through. It says it's a pigment ink, but it's a special blend, and so it does have some bleed through. So we will look at that. And that one's that here. I do like the VersaFine because it has this unique property to where you get very good stamping. As you can see, some of these other ones are kind of blurry or mottled or not very good impressions. The VersaFine, you get a really clean, crisp image with this ink, and that's why I like it. Stays on ink. I know a lot of people use this ink. I do not use this ink in my Bible any longer. I used to start out using it, but it is a solvent ink, so it's very tough on your stamps. It's hard to clean off. It is permanent once it's dry, and you can stamp on things like plastics and fabrics and you know, mediums like that. So I will use it for things like that, but on Bible pages, I don't because it is kind of hard on my stamps. I have people say that it doesn't bleed through Bible pages. I have it bleed through. And so we will look at that. It is permanent once it's dry, so you can watercolor over it. Distress Oxide inks. I was pretty sure this is going to bleed through because it's a dye-based ink. It's dye and pigment, but dye-based. Any dye-based products, whether it's, it says it's a watercolor pen or an ink pen or anything that has the word dye, is most likely going to bleed through any Bible page, really. So I anticipate these to bleed through, the Distress Oxide inks, but I thought I would give it a go. These are reactive with water and actually bleed even more once you've added water. So I didn't add water to any of these inks, but just keep that in mind. Gina K Amalgam ink. This is a new ink to me that I picked out to try. Picked up to try out. This was not marketed for Bible journaling. It's actually marketed towards scrapbookers and card makers. I believe it's a dye-based ink, but it's a special blend to where you can use it with watercolors and Copic markers, alcohol markers, colored pencils. So it's kind of a do-all ink, but I anticipated this one to bleed through. Another thing I thought was interesting are the Gina K inks. I have purchased several of these in different colors. These are really beautiful on cardstocks because they stamp kind of blotchy, but then they smooth out and become really creamy and pretty. But on Bible pages, they don't tend to smooth out like they do on cardstock. And so I could see that here. It was really uneven stamping. So I don't know that I will be stamping these directly into my Bible. Colorbox chalk inks. I've mentioned these on my channel before. Initially, when I discovered these, I discovered that they are permanent once they're heat set, so you can watercolor over them. And the colors I had tried didn't bleed through my Bible page, but I had some people comment that it was bleeding in their Bibles, and so I picked up some more colors and found that the darker colors do have a tendency to bleed through. So I pulled out the black cherry to stamp and see how that would work. It is kind of nice that it's permanent once it's dry and you can use, you know, water over it and stuff like that, but I thought I would give it a go. I also went ahead and just inked up with a Faber-Castell big brush marker. These, it just depends. If I have a lot of ink on the stamp, it'll bleed through in my other Bible, and sometimes it won't bleed through. Also depends on the color of the pen or how new the pen is, but these will sometimes bleed through if I stamp with it, so I went ahead and did that. Ranger Archival ink, that's one that a lot of people use. Again, that's kind of like Stazon, where it's supposed to be permanent. It bleeds through for me, and actually you're supposed to be able to stamp over gesso and stamp over plastic and things like that, but mine just never really ever sets, so I don't like to use archival ink in my Bible, but I did go ahead and try it out. I also tried the Illustrated Faith pigment ink. This ink is not permanent once it's dry, so it will move with water, but it's not supposed to bleed through your Bible pages, so I know a lot of people like this because it doesn't bleed through. So let's take a look here. I would stick with using either the VersaFine Onyx Black ink or the Illustrated Faith pigment ink. Everything else had bleed through. This is the Stazon. The Stazon even bled through over to the next page. This is Distress Oxide. This is the Gina K. Colorbox chalk. Big brush marker. You can see it starting to bleed through in some areas where there was a lot of ink. The archival ink is starting to bleed through. So, you know, just keep that in mind. And once you add water, it's even more likely to bleed through. Now, I didn't try anything with gesso. That was just way more experimenting than I think is necessary. That's once you've layered gesso over a page, you're really testing out the gesso in the product, not the Bible in the product, because that gesso creates a layer. So I didn't do that. But so yeah, I would stick with the VersaFine Onyx Black ink or the Illustrated Faith. And you can see the VersaFine doesn't bleed through too bad. That's just really heavy shadowing. So let's talk about pens, because pens apply whether you're doing art journaling or whether you're doing note taking. So let's take a look at some of the different pens that I used in here. Okay, lots and lots of pens, and most of these are permanent once they are dry, so you can go over them with watercolor or water products or whatever. So Pitt Artist Pens, these are the Faber-Castell Pitt Artist Pens. That is this one here. I tried out the Tombow Feud Calligraphy Pen. This is the one that's been kind of my go-to. It's a little bit thicker of a brush nib, and so you get thicker lines, but I just really like that you can kind of get that faux calligraphy look, and they hold up better over a variety of products. So I tried that. The Pigma Micron pen, that's this one here, and then the Sharpie pen, the Illustrated Faith journaling pen, and so these all typically do not bleed through in my Crossway journaling Bible. The Tombow Feud will, if I go over the same area multiple times or I'm really heavy-handed, I will get some bleed through, but I don't typically have bleed through with any of these other pens, so I was just kind of curious to see how that would work. I also pulled out some colored pens. I know there's a lot of different ones out there. I don't have the Illustrated Faith ones. I haven't invested in those yet just because I have a lot of other colored pens, but the Staedtler Tripless Fine Liners. That's this one here. And then the Arteza fine liners. These are supposed to be kind of the knockoff of the Staedtler pens. They are supposed to be permanent once they are dry or heat set. I still get some movement with water. And so I wouldn't use them with, you know, water over the top, but it is kind of fun to use colored ink sometimes. So on the back side here, not really any bleed through. You do get some bleed through, and I'll see if I can show this to you. The Pitt Artist and the Micron pens are fine. Those don't bleed through at all. But the Tombow Feud, the Sharpie, and the Illustrated Faith, as well as the Staedtler and the Arteza, anywhere where I end a letter, and kind of hold the pen there for a second, it does start to bleed through. So if you were to go over something multiple times, I think you would start to get bleed through. This box that I did was done with a Micron pen and went over it several times. I didn't get bleed through. And then this box was done with the Illustrated Faith pen. I didn't really get bleed through. It is heavy shadowing. So some of you might be calling that bleed through. That's not bleed through. That's just really dark shadowing. If you don't even like the shadowing, I would stick with either a Pitt Artist pen or the Micron pen. Those are the two lightest pens that seem to work on there. And these, same thing, the colored pens, they don't bleed through. I imagine if you use darker colors or went over them several times, you will start to get some bleed through. But if you're just writing really quick and being kind of light-handed, it doesn't bleed through too bad. So I would stick with Pitt Artist pens or Micron pens if you're wanting to avoid bleed through at all. But you can really use any of those and work just fine. So there are pens. And these are mostly like a felt tip pen. And so you do have to be careful. You do want to try to write upright. And just be careful about writing over. You don't want to write over wet paint or wet gesso. You're going to kind of ruin these pens. So, and they do have a tendency to dry out if you leave them uncapped. But if you're going to be writing with like a ballpoint pen or something like that, those aren't going to do so well on here. So you do, even if you're just taking notes or writing prayers, you do want to pick up a nicer pen. So let's talk about some art journaling products. So if you're somebody who is into art journaling, let's kind of talk about some of those different products and how those react in this Bible. Okay, like I said, I tried lots of stuff, but I didn't try everything. But see, these are some of the things that you see quite often on my channel. Big brush markers, whether you use big brush markers or the smaller artist pen brush markers, these react pretty similarly on Bible paper. I just swatched out the big brush marker. These in my Crossway Bible have a tendency to bleed through if I'm really heavy-handed. So I went over this twice. That seems to be kind of the limit. If I go over it 3, 4, 5 times, it does start to bleed through. But these are nice. They're India ink, so they're permanent once they dry. They're great for highlighting. They are a little bit pricey, but it is nice to know that it's not going to bleed through unless you're super heavy-handed. Inktense pencils. These I don't have a problem with bleeding in my Bible. These are an India dye-based watercolor pencil, and India ink, not India dye. India ink, excuse me. India ink based watercolor pencil. And they are permanent once they dry. I don't have a problem with these bleeding through, but I have had some comments from people that they've had bleed through in their Bible. So I was curious to see. I try to pick a little bit darker of a color to see what the bleed through was like. And I did add water to that. So I laid down, scribbled on the paper, and then went over it with water. NeoColor 2 crayons. These are a watercolor crayon. I don't really have a problem with these bleeding through. Some of the darker colors, sometimes if I'm really heavy-handed, but for the most part, these don't really bleed through. Prima watercolors. Those are what I have in this tin that you see on my channel. That's these ones here. And then the Daniel Smith are these ones down here. These are a artist grade watercolor. And then these are a craft watercolor. So I tried those out. And then the Kiritaki Gonzai Tombi. These actually aren't watercolors. I will link a video down below talking about Gonzai. So these are actually Gonzai, but they're marketed as watercolors. They're very similar to watercolors. It's just a different binder that holds together the pigment. And these are super, super rich pigmented color. And you can see that's the darkest color that's on the page there. I haven't really heard any of you saying that these bleed through, but I thought I would give it a try. They don't bleed through in my Bible that I use on my channel. So I did try that. And then the Illustrated Faith watercolors. I will be honest, I like these because I like that the colors match Illustrated Faith products, but I have had issues with some of these having a tendency to occasionally bleed through. Kind of the pinks, the blues, the darker colors. If I'm layering up color, will have a tendency to have some bleed through. I don't know if you guys have had the same thing happen, but I do have that. So I thought I would try that. I was kind of curious to see. So let's take a look on the back here. The big brush marker is starting to come through on that second layer of marker. If I was to lay another layer, it would come through. But if you're just going to go over it once, you shouldn't have a problem. None of the watercolors, even that Kiritaki Gonzai Tombi. This, remember, is that super, super rich pigmented green watercolor. That is actually the lightest shadowing, second to like the Daniel Smith watercolor on here. So if you're looking for a watercolor that won't bleed through in this Bible, that would be a great one. And the Primas, again, don't bleed through. Neo color twos, no bleed through, some shadowing, ink tents, shadowing, but no bleed through. Here are the Illustrated Faith watercolor. You're starting to see it want to bleed through. So if that bothers you, you may want to stay away from the Illustrated Faith watercolors in this Bible. And again, this is all pretty much 99.9% similar to the Crossway Bible as far as products I can use and how they behave. So if you are watching my channel and wanting to follow along with the products that I use and want to make sure that they are reacting a similar way for you, but you like this translation and like some of the features of this Bible better, then I think this would be a great option for you guys to pick up. I really have enjoyed the quality of this Bible, and actually the more I've read in the New King James Version, it's been fine. It doesn't bother me. I thought that I would have a hard adjustment period just because that's not what I usually read, but I haven't minded that, and they are just gorgeous, gorgeous Bibles. So this is the one that's going to be part of the giveaway. The giveaway is going to run until August 22nd. I will have all that information in the description box, as well as links to where you can pick up these Bibles. For the giveaway to enter, what you need to do, you need to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment down below with your favorite Bible verse. What is your favorite Bible verse? So those three things will be your entry into the giveaway. The rest of the details will be in the description box, so check that out. The giveaway is for US only. I'm so sorry. I have to pay for the shipping and do all the customs if I have to ship out of country, and it's a little bit of a hassle. So it's for US only. So sorry, guys. Hopefully in the future, I'll be able to partner with a company that can do a international giveaway for me, but for now it's for US. And so yeah, make sure that you get all set up to win the giveaway, and I will leave a comment on your comment if you are the winner, and also try to message you through the YouTube messaging system, which should send you an email. So be sure to stay on top of that. I have several prizes in my office where giveaway winners won, but then never reached back out to me to give me their information to get stuff sent out. So make sure that you come back and visit the video on, let's say, August 23rd is when the winner will be announced. So definitely come back and see if you won this Bible. And in the meantime, go check out Thomas Nelson Bibles, see what they have over there. They are gorgeous, good quality Bibles. I've really enjoyed this one and think you guys will too. So if you have any questions or comments, you can leave those down below as well. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. And thank you to Thomas Nelson Bibles for sponsoring this video. And until next time, thank you so much. Bye-bye.